meteorologist Scott Dorval.
Take a look at this 3-degree guarantee. Hit 83 is what I expected for the high temperature during the day today. We did hit 84 degrees this afternoon, and boy, light winds. Just a spectacular evening still going on out there. We did have those high clouds dimming that sunshine in Ada County, but many folks are seeing crystal clear skies and a nice warm up in those temperatures. So the real cool weather that blasted in is kind of retreating to the north and to the east, and the warm air is just moving back in. It's kind of breaking up that cool weather. So you see the 80s officially 84 in Boise, not 83, 83 in Twin. And there's that heat again in Colorado. You see the numbers here, 97 in Denver, 99 degrees in Grand Junction, 89 Salt Lake, 105 in Vegas. So there's a lot of heat to the south. And look, just east of Colorado, very brown over there. Those temperatures are above 100 degrees. We had some thunderstorms in central Colorado. We'll take a look at that here in just a second. I want to first of all go to the Boise Valley Asthma and Allergy Clinic's pollen count today, down to the low category at a 21. It is still grass and pine, but really not too much of an issue going on. Here's the picture across the northwest, and you'll see that again, the forecast for tomorrow, we see very warm conditions indeed, as those temperatures will continue to surge in from the south. What's going to happen now in central Colorado is that we had some showers and thunderstorms nearby, and it looks like we could see a few more of those developing as well. In fact, it is likely tomorrow afternoon. Now, it would be great to get a nice heavy downpour. One good thunderstorm could cover a good portion of that fire, but it would have to be right overhead. Unfortunately, you always have erratic gusty winds with thunderstorms, and that's what's going to be occurring from southeast portions of Wyoming down through central Colorado and points to the south, even in eastern portions of Utah during the day tomorrow. And so it's those erratic gusty winds that give the firefighters headaches as they're dealing with this when they're trying to set up lines around some of the homes here. It is likely to develop again tomorrow. Winds are fairly light around the region now. There's some rain to the south of Colorado Springs, but it is not over the top of that fire, which could certainly be a big help. We may get that tomorrow. You never know. Here's this weekend's forecast. Scorching heat still down in the south central area and right around Colorado as well, but we still have a chance of thunderstorms through Friday and Saturday as well. Jet stream backs on off, and so hotter weather for Saturday. And if we head towards Sunday, I think temperatures will drop down just a little bit. Here's my forecast for the day tomorrow. Mostly sunny, light northwest breeze, but it will be hotter. 95 in Mountain Home, 91 in Meridian. Caldwell checks it at 90 for the high temperature tomorrow. With the West Central Mountains, beautiful weather. Near 40 in the morning in McCall, but up to 78 in the afternoon. Lots of sunshine. A picture-perfect day out on Payette Lake for the day tomorrow. Garden Valley comes close to 90, as most towns in Boise County will be seeing the same. Sunshine in Twin Falls at 92, 89 in Shoshone. Stanley tomorrow, by the way, will be about 30 in the morning and 81 in the afternoon. Just amazing afternoon weather coming on it. Let's take a look at this on your side extended forecast. 93 for tomorrow. Drops a little bit on Friday, a little bit of a breeze. Not too much, though, at 88. It gets hot again on Saturday. So Thursday and Saturday are going to shape out to be just about the same. Then on Sunday, those temperatures will drop back to the 80s. Could be a little bit breezy on Sunday. I still think there's a chance of some thunderstorms in the Central Mountains and maybe a shower in the Treasure Valley on Sunday morning. And then on Monday, Tuesday and Wednesday. Wednesday is the 4th of July. I got to put some fireworks or a flag on that Wednesday there. I think it's going to be your typical standard summer weather. There's a chance of some thunderstorms in the mountains Tuesday night, but I don't see it right now. Wednesday night is something you always have to watch. So we have to watch out for some gusty winds that might affect some fireworks. But it will be hot and dry. It's not going to be cool and wet. And so be careful when dealing with any fireworks that you may have.
Yes, most definitely. Tomorrow's hot.
Feel
yes,
like
summer.
Yes.
Okay. Thanks, Scott.
You bet.
Well, the